strands of pain and sorrow, tears of the poor and helpless, hearts are torn in anguish. From where will there help come? So badly, happiness no more known, hurting the more we get. Save us this pang of pain. Is gone, my strength is gone. Where could he ever be? My heart is torn, my feet are weak. Could he ever leave? Mine, oh mine, hear them cry.
Remove from them strains of pain. Chichi. Chichi.
Yeah.
Let us go.
Osita, why? We have not finished this work. Huh?
I want us to go. I am not feeling fine.
Osita, you were very, very okay at home before we came to this farm to work. What is wrong with you now? Are you sick?
It's not as if that I'm sick, but I'm feeling somehow as if my mind is jumping out of me.
Osita. See, I want you to remember something. Osita, I have to go back to the city for my job. All I have is just this weekend to finish this thing I'm doing. Osita, please, let us finish it. Or do you want me to come in every weekend just because I have to clear this land? Osita, please now, be strong and let us finish it and go home.
But we can always come next time to finish the job.
Osita, I'll come back another weekend just because of it. No, now. Let us finish it at home.
Yes, boss. Yes, sir. What? I'll do that right away before you come for your normal inspection. I'll try my best. No problem, boss. Bye-bye. Well, we have an additional job to do.
Tempest, what is that?
The boss just called saying he won a contract of supplying drugs to his client. And what about 12 million naira? The drugs are expected to land the country within 4 days.
Meaning? We had to kidnap more people and bring them here to work.
Exactly, Hammer. It seems you read my mind. Cobra, Skido, Skull, and you, Zeal, you go with me for assignments.
While Scorpion and Hammer keeps watch over the people.
Is that okay? So, let's get going.
Tell me you are tired, we must work to do.
Did I say I'm running away? I'm not tired. I'm just pressed. I want to eat myself.
Come on, get down. How long will you keep quiet?
Now pull off your clothes. First. I said pull off your clothes. I see you want me to do that by force.
Yes.
Do with these girls.
I don't just want it. Don't play it on me. Oh, Sita.
Hey.
Oh, see. Oh, Sita. Oh, my God.
Accompany me to the farm. Let me confirm what my daughter is telling me. Please.
Is that what you want us to do?
That's not what I want us to do now.
Let us go.
Okay. Where is the way to the farm?
Okay.
That's good.
Thank you.
sorry.
Can you move over there?
Gotta move over this way, man.
You get that? Just stay, man. So, you have to move over here now.
Move it, boy!
Tempest!
Sir!
Are these the new recruited employed workers?
Yes, sir.
I can see you just brought them in, because they were not here yesterday when I visited here.
Yes, sir, we had a following order from the phone call, and we have to displace the order. Yes, sir.
It's a good and swift recruitment movement you have here. Any casualty?
Yes, sir. We're just complaining of hunger.
Hunger?
Shut up,
boy!
Sir!
When you get back to the city, make sure you get to the woman in charge. That meals, okay?
No problem, sir!
Good.
Are these your son's shirts, trousers, and slippers?
Yes. They are.
Oh! I could not read his mind. Papa, please take me. Kill me and let his blood be on me. Because I caused his death.
It is alright, my daughter. It is alright. Look, I understand how you are feeling. But what do we do about it now?
This is not the right place for us to talk about this. Let's get home first.
You are right, Tayamani. I think we have to go to the village and get our youths organized to search for him.
You are correct, Wabarocha. But I think it will be wise we report this to the police before it is too late.
You are right. But everything will be discussed by the time we get home. Let us go. Let us go, everybody. Let us go.
Have you lost your hope in Christ? Have you forgotten that all things work it for the good of those who love him? Have you forgotten all this? My
mama said it all.
But then, listen, it's okay.
My brother has summed it up. He said God has given, he has also taken. Who are we to question him? We cannot challenge God. It's all right. It's all right.
What is the position of that land business you have with Nanyi Beribula?
Which land business?
I mean that land that you used to borrow money from you.
Okay, yes. What about the land?
No. I want us to take away that land from him. Now listen. His son, Osita, who should have taken over the land, is now dead.
Then very soon, that is that one that they call Chinecherem, will get married and leave. And then Nai Eberebulan will also soon die. Then what do you expect to happen on that land? You want other people to come and claim our land?
How do you mean, Enyidia? I don't understand what you are talking about.
Nai, what agreement did you have with him on that land?
Well, he borrowed some money from me quite all right, and then gave out the land for collateral.
That's not the answer to my question.
Okay. The agreement was that he has to pay 60% of the money within 3 months.
Yes.
Or forfeit the land if he fails to pay that amount of money at a specified period.
Good. Now, has he complied with that?
Oh, yes, yes. I mean, he has paid up to 60% of that. Even more than that, I think he has paid me up to 80%.
Oh, my God.
What sort of statement is that, Elidia? No, what do you have in mind?
This is the golden opportunity we have to take away that land from him.
But how? He has almost paid up the money. He's left with only 20%, which I know he can bring to me any moment from now.
That is the reason why we must act very, very fast. Nine, remember, the government has taken over that area of land for the construction of a housing estate.
How do you mean? I don't understand.
Nine, tomorrow morning, you must go and place palm leaf on that land. Then you go to the council of elders and report Eberebulan to them. Tell them that he used that land as a collateral to borrow money from you. And that since he has not met up with your agreement, that you want to take back your land. As simple as that.
How? He has paid some money.
Nani, I know he has. Just pretend he has not. Nine, the government is going to splash money heavily on the owners of the plots of land in that area. And you know what it means. Such big money is going to change even our lifestyles. Biko Jim, Biko, I beg.
Hey, dear.
Nine.
How do you want me to do this to Eberebula?
Enoka.
He's my kinsman and the brother. He's a quiet and peaceful man. I don't think he deserves all these things that you want us to do to him. After all, he gives no problem to anybody.
Say what? Get out of where? So you don't know that this was a thing here?
How? Why?
So how do you mean? So you don't know that the man did television sets everywhere that you can hardly see them. Look, if you make any movement, you're in trouble with them.
The mounted cameras here.
Yes, the mounted cameras at every certain equations, of which if you make any problem, you are dead.
What's the name?
Annord. Yes, Mr. Annord. What? For human consumption? Yes. See, we have customers everywhere, even in the township. Why some? Many of them are in the rural areas and villages.
Thank you so fine.
No, they make me so.
He's trying.
Which day you come back?
I came back last night.
Last night because the team be say, now God don't make you carry ahead in return. Nothing happened to you.
James, so how are you doing?
I do all right. Oga, they do me fine.
What about my mother-in-law? My father-in-law? It's not my husband, Ara.
Until be as Oga business day, sometime they day, sometime no day, no person know they sabi the time where in day. But Oga day with a law, even Judith, okay. That Oga is sister, he day inside.
I have something for you, it's in the book, but later on.
Hey, Auntie Francis! Every time where you go in Glamour, I'm happy. Nice. Yeah, because if they carry something, give me something. You're welcome.
And helpless. Hearts are torn in anguish. From where will their help come? Mine, oh mine, hear them cry.
They have to answer.
Chuck, you're welcome.
Thank you very much. When did you get back?
Yesterday night.
Yeah, how was your trip?
It was looking smooth.
Looking so big.
So nice moment.
They are falling upstairs. They're laughing.
Oh, I'm so tired. Very, very tired.
And so what did you get back?
Oh my God.
Why don't you just allow me to at least relax?
Okay.
Whatever. So it's good. It's fine, just lectures of your stress.
It's not my like that everywhere.
Okay.
So where is mommy? Can't wait to see them.
Okay, then go get them. Oh, there they come.
Oh, Frances, my daughter. My dear, you're welcome.
Thank you very much.
You're looking good.
Thank you, mommy.
When did you come back?
Last night.
Frances, you're back.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Well, where is my husband? I called him. I called him back yesterday.
Yes. He got the call. Betty has gone to work.
Work.
Well, please sit down.
Thank you.
And tell me how you enjoy your stay in London.
Not until she has taken something. Judith, come. Let's go and prepare something special for my daughter-in-law. You're welcome, my dear.
Thank you. Something special, because you are a special person here.
Yes, Daddy. You're looking so fresh. Younger.
Well, we thank God.
Chinichiro.
Yes, ma'am.
You have to go back to the city. So that you don't lose your job.
Papa. Then we have not finished the work on that land.
I know. Forget about that for now. Go back to the city and continue your work.
Che, if you really have to go to work at that land, you can't do that alone. You went there with your brother and you people were attacked. Then you want to go there. No, now it's dangerous. We can run. Mama. I quite understand what you're saying. But we cannot leave that land uncultivated. Remember, the government has mapped out that area of land for a housing estate. So, if we do not cultivate the land, they will take it from us without proper compensation. And besides, if actually we have handed over our problems to God concerning Osita, my brother, I think we can continue working on that farm. And then forget about the sad memories this issue has brought to this family. Mama, I know it is not easy, but I'm sure we can try.
I understand. You can go back to the farm. You can go back to the farm and continue your work, but
it's dangerous.
I don't think you'll be safe.
I'm not safe, Papa.
You can't go there alone.
There is nothing to worry about. I will hire some laborers to go with me to the farm. No, you are talking.
That's a good one. That's much better.
Nani, for barely 1 month now, I've been telling you to do something about that land. Yes, Nani, you must do something. No. Nothing will happen to you. Nothing. Ebere Bulam cannot do anything. I am your wife. Just believe what I'm telling you. Just nothing will happen to you.
You mean I should take one front and barricade the land?
Exactly. That is what you must do. And then he will now come out to ask who did that on his farm. Then that will be an opportunity for you to now tell the whole village that he used that land as a collateral to borrow money from you. And that because he has not met up with the agreement, that you want your land back. You want to take back your land, that's all.
Look, what happens if he brings out the documents to prove me wrong?
Which documents? Hey! Nay, which documents? Deny ever knowing anything about any documents. In fact, you have not seen any documents. You don't know anything about the documents. Let the village know that he is telling lies. He is a liar. Huh?
That is true, my wife.
But he may insist though. Now, if he insists, also insist. You cannot tell the village to make him swear an oath with the ROC of Idemog. And you know that is the last thing Ebere Bulam will do now. He cannot do that.
That is true, my wife. That is the truth. Oh, Obidia, you are wonderful.
Man,
I thought you forgot.
You are wonderful.
That is me now.
Ah. Hey dear, you are a woman of substance.
Nani.
The Iron Lady herself.
I was almost getting afraid that you forgot.
The one that swims and baths in wisdom.
That is my husband talking. You are the man that married me now.
The way you talk is wisdom.
Yes, sir.
The way you walk is wisdom. The way you laugh is wisdom.
You see?
Even the way you eat is full of wisdom.
Nay.
No wonder. No wonder. Our people say that behind any successful man, that there must be a brilliant woman behind him.
Nine, that is true. That is the truth.
Sit down, sit down, sit down, my wife. Sit down.
You know, I almost got afraid now that you forgot all these things. A very bulam cannot do anything. That man, he can never take any oath.
You are very right. You know, by the time I will ask him to swear, and he refuses, automatically, that land becomes ours.
Simple. As simple as that.
In fact, both the land and the 80% that he had already paid will not be ours.
You see? Now we don't have any problem again.
That the land when we go work.
Yes, sir. But I don't need my father came here.
Now they put palm fruit here.
Maya Yameli, what are you doing on my father's land? I hope this thing you are putting here is your family.
Oh, well. My father's land. Anyway, you are too small to discuss land issues with me.
But I don't understand what you're saying. This is my father's land, and you know that too well. And that is the main reason why I hired these laborers to come and work here.
Go and tell your father to come and prove to me how this land belongs to me.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And you, the boss, I don't want to see your feet beside this land. Of course, they know what the punishment will be if they do.
Gentlemen, please, I'm very sorry for what has taken place now. Please give me time to resolve it. But nevertheless, I'm still going to pay you for the day's job.
It's okay, it's okay.
Amaju, I think what we did to that girl is not good at all.
How? Itamene, you hear what Idiala talk? Diala, make I tell you, a day job is a day job. After all, if he no call us, he still for goes for another place they do the same work. So I don't understand how we take cheat.
Okay, if he saw we cheat him, you too. Oh, you're making give us back your
Give you back.
Move yes, gonna take her and give me. But all I know is that the thing what we do today is no good at all.
You can have the money. You can have the money to
you. Only let God forgive us for later.
This is Opu, and I make the sacrifice for your government work.
No, before government work.
No, before government work. Now, for company, your company where he work. Job, you no great job. Give another person chance to come and make him angry. You no great.
I got that much reason.
Ah, now you make the God for one bring from up. Come from and down.
There's a lot
of I'm not sure you might be all the money. It's supposed to be supposed to.
No.
Papa! 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 Mama!
I'm sure there's nobody in this house.
What is it? You took some people to the farm.
This has never happened in my life before.
What is it now?
Mama, we could not walk. How? I met Naya Emily at the farm. And he walked us out of the farm. That we cannot walk in that farm. That the land belongs to him.
How?
Mama, how?
I don't know.
How? That it belongs to him.
Yes, Mama.
That land belongs to him.
Yes, Mama.
How?
Babu! Ihojo! That land belongs to him!
Yes!
Jesus Christ, your father must hear this.
Where is he, ma?
No, he's not here. He went to see Nahidika.
He will come back.
You are welcome.
Are you Nachi?
No.
Chinachi. Is there anything the problem?
No. Just ask your daughter what happened in the front.
Chinachi.
Papa.
What happened? What happened?
Papa, I took the laborers to the farm tomorrow. When I got there, I saw Nayame.
Nayame?
I saw him putting some palm leaf on the farm, barricading the whole place. He asked us out of the farm, that farm is not ours, that he is the owner of the land. Papa. Nine. Papa, what is going on?
Nine.
Are you still waiting? You are keeping quiet. Nine, I thought you told me you have paid him close to 80% of the said amount.
Huh? No. I have paid him exactly 80% of the said amount.
Why is he still barricading with palm fronds?
But I think something must be wrong somewhere. Something is wrong somewhere.
Papa, where are you going to? Where are you going to?
Let me go and see Anyamele.
Oh.
Let us resolve this.
Hey. If you want to go, please go, but please don't make any troubles.
You should know me. I don't fight. I don't quarrel.
Yes.
I have to go and find out why you did this.
Papa, please. I'm not ready to lose a father yet.
Papa, is he big on
I will quarrel with him. I promise.
I hope you've not come in connection with that land that I've placed the palm front on. My daughter has told me everything, and that you asked them not to walk on that land. Oh, is that what you have come to confirm? Yes, and do you know why? You want to know why? Have you paid me the amount of money you borrowed from me for that portion of land?
What are you saying? Have you forgotten our agreement?
What is our agreement?
That I should pay 60% of the total amount borrowed within the first 3 months, and thereafter pay the balance of 40% within 2 months. And I know that within the first 3 months I've paid you 80%. What I'm now owing you is 20%.
You have not paid me up to 60% of the money you borrowed from me, not to talk of 80%.
What are you talking about? I hope you're not playing games with my land.
Me? Playing games with your land? Now, remember that you are supposed to pay me 40%. within 3 months and failure to pay up to 60% within that 3 months, that I will confiscate that land. And that's exactly what I have just done.
Nai, what is it?
Can you imagine a very ulama coming to tell me that he has paid me 80% of that money to me on that land when he has not even paid up to 60%?
So what did you tell him?
Of course I told him that he has not even paid up to 60% on that land.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore I'm taking possession of that land.
Of course. That is what it's supposed to be.
And that's what it is.
Chine,
yes, Mama.
Please come.
Mama, what is
it? And your father is saying rather too long. I hope he's all well with him.
I thought as much. Why don't you go and check on him?
Please go. Let me just
go. Go! What are you?
Mama, did you lock the door?
Let the door go.
Don't you go, Ebelebula.
Go now, go!
I am early. I can see that you are drunk. I've never seen you in this mood before. I don't know what led you into this kind of thing. Your poverty.
Good.
Meanwhile, who told you that I'm drunk?
I wonder.
It's you that is drunk. Eh? It's you that is very drunk. And if you think that you have come to my house to insult and abuse me, then the villagers will come and meet all of us.
Nani, what is it? Papa, what is it?
Nani.
Now, take your family and get out of my compound immediately. Anyamel, if you think you can forcefully take away my land, well, the God I serve will deal with you.
Oh God! What a foolish man! Is it not the same God that you have been calling and that they kidnapped your own
son?
No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no,
there is no problem. Huh?
Chiricha.
So you're sitting like this, Papa. What was Nayoka Defense Mission?
Well, I've been summoned to a meeting of the Council of Elders.
Why?
Over that land, Anyamel went and reported to the Council of Elders that I went about town telling people that he forcefully took my land.
Nani, have you given him the land?
I have not given him the land.
Then, let us go to the Council of Elders and ruffle it out there with them.
Cause now, Mama.
It is not only that.
What else?
He also said that I'm expected to swear to an oath.
Swear to an oath? You swear to an oath?
What are we going to do about this oath-taking?
Oath-taking? You already know that I'm not going to take any oath. It is against my belief.
Nani, I hope you are not telling me that you will allow Nayanyamele to take that land.
We don't have any other option. Should I go to swear to an oath because I want to claim my land?
Nani?
No.
Nani, kiga abulamu. Nani, I am becoming so fed up of you and your attitudes. Nani, how are we going to lose everything we have just because of your belief and strict attachment to religion? Nani, we lost the only son we have. Was it Adema? We lost him to kidnappers. And when the villagers came to advise you on what to do, you were like delivering a sermon on the mount. My people, let us leave everything to the hands of God. God give it and God take it. And that was it, man. Now, the only land we have in the whole village is about being taken away from us. And you are there sitting down. I don't want to take an home. Nan. And that was the way the other lands went. Because you were not man enough to contest them with your opponents. Mama, shut up.
So Nyenachi, let me ask you. What then do you want me to do in the present circumstance? Let me hear from you.
Now you are talking. Just take the simple way out. Take this oath. And you will prove to the villagers that one, we are the bona fide owners of that land. And then two, that you really paid the 80% he was claiming. Unless you did not pay.
So the simple way out is that I should go and swear to an oath against my own belief.
What is wrong in doing that? What is wrong in doing that? What is wrong with swearing an oath? Have you not heard or even read the Bible of people who swore oaths? Anyway, this last straw will certainly break the camel's back. If by the way you attend this meeting and you are back without swearing the oath and without claiming that land. Now, in short, I will die. I will just commit suicide and I will die. After all, what does it take? What does it even really mean to stay married to a man who does not even know his right?
Mama, stop it! Stop pouring all those venom on Papa! Mama, it is too much.
A man who is not man enough to protect his family. A man who cannot stand his ground when it comes to matters like...
Mama!
You shut up! Shut your trap! A man who is just there for being a man. A man who does not even who does not even own up to when responsibilities are there. Anyway, just go for that meeting and come back without reclaiming that man. Then I will know what to do.
Papa, I'm so sorry for all Mama has said to you. Please forgive her. You know she's not in her right frame of mind as it is now. Considering the fact that she lost her only son and now the only piece of land she cultivates is about to be taken from her. Papa, please forgive her. And don't take all those things she has said to you. Don't take them to heart. Papa, please.
Chinecha.
Papa.
You know the type of person I am. I hold nothing against your mother. She's my wife. I have never thought of anything against her. It is just that she doesn't seem to understand anymore. She has lost faith in God. Let me tell you this. There is nobody who came into this life with anything. So when we are going, we go with nothing. Why then should we struggle and kill ourselves over the things of this world? This land has been in existence before we came. And when we die, we are buried in it. So why then should I go to swear to an oath against my belief because of a mere piece of land?
If I know you will not swear, but forgive her.
I'm forgiving her, don't worry.
Thank you.
Yes. I told you, do this thing. Have you worked with this syndicate for not less than four good years now? Still, you think that you should ignore my words and overlook my advice? If that does not want to listen to an advice, will surely follow the course to the grave.
That guy over there is looking at us.
No, I'm not here to. He knows what he has against us.
He has anything against us.
You know,
he's as trapped as we are here, enslaved in this hell. Maybe he's trying to establish a kind of relationship with us.
You must certainly escape from this place.
But for your information, don't depend on those guys. We don't know them. We don't know why they are here. We equally don't know how they were brought here. So we must have to plan and look for any way and means of escape.
Honestly speaking, if someone tells me that up till now they will be here without taking my bath, without food, without my parents, I won't believe it. So we must have to plan and leave this place.
I see that. How? These people have monitored television scattered and hidden all over the bush. Besides, they have the call. So, how do we escape from here with all these obstacles before us?
We must certainly escape from this place. Tonight will probably be the last night that I'm going to sleep in this dungeon. And I expect the both of you to cooperate with me.
But Chideka, how do we achieve this?
How? Listen, one of them is casting his eyes on me. Last night, when we were sleeping, he kept watching us. Both of you were asleep, but I was awake. I watched him looking at our lapses with lust. Suddenly, I opened my eyes to let him know that I knew what he was about doing. Then he withdrew and went back to his duty post. We shall use him. I expect the both of you to cooperate with me and do exactly what I ask you to do in this contest.
We are better not sitting there waiting for one of them screaming.
You've heard what Anyamele said. This was exactly what he told us at the meeting the other day. So we have invited you to come along and tell us your own version of the story.
I want to state it clear that Anyamele has lied against me.
I tell lies against you?
Please allow him to land before you attack him. He did not interrupt you when you were talking.
Anyamele, you have to allow a man die before you bury him. Eh? Allow Eberebulem to come down first before you interrupt. Eberebulem, go ahead.
As I was saying before, I want to state that Anyamele lied against me. I have paid him 80% of the amount I borrowed from him. What is now remaining is just 20%. Our initial agreement was that within the first 3 months, I will pay him 60%. But I went beyond that. Before the end of the 3 months, I've already paid him 80%. So for him to turn around now and barricade my land with palm leaves simply suggests that he wants to take away my land by force.
Ooh.
Is that not fraudulent?
The truth of the matter is that Eberebulem gave me 40,000 naira, representing 40% of the total amount of money he borrowed from me. Eberebulem, you cannot start telling lies. You can't tell lies on me now. You can't.
What is this?
Yes.
Hey!
What kind of nonsense is this, for goodness sake? Eh? Are we here for a child's play? Are we gathered for tests by moonlight? Eh? Why must you people be arguing amongst yourselves? Deny every question that is put across to you. Look, if you don't want us to tell us the truth, how do we now know how to solve the problem?
Especially now that the government has taken over the land. Eh? To make to establish an estate and construct the road.
They would like to take the land without paying any compensation to any of you. Because since the land is on dispute, nobody will pay you any farthing.
I want you to look at this.
This is the paper he signed, confirming the said amount I paid to him. I want you to pass it on. Is this not his signature?
Can see it.
Not your signature.
Onya Kabulam, no.
Ma'am.
This is not my signature. This is a forged signature.
Yes.
The only way of knowing the truth is by taking an oath. Since Ebere Bulam is insisting that he has paid me up to 80% of the total amount he borrowed from me, then he will swear for me.
Nice.
At the ROC in the Morocco.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I swear. Anyway, if my husband has to swear, you too must swear.
Why?
Shut up, yes. Woman. This is not a woman affair. Oh, eh? Any man is correct in what he's saying. After all, he's the man who brought this case to the village council square and meeting. Eh? Since your husband is denying all the charges brought against him, it is the man who brought this charge that will impose him to swear for him. Eh? So Anima is in order.
Okadike.
Okadike.
Hearing you.
That woman is correct. She is correct. Now listen. Ayamele must also take an oath to say that he collected 40% of the something from Ebere Bulam. Both of them are involved in this case and they should take an oath. Yes!
I don't accept that, Didika.
It is not correct. Anyamele has nothing to do with oath taking in this matter. It is the accused, Ebere Bulam, who has to take an oath to clear himself from the accusation leveled against him.
Bichie and others present, there's no need taking this matter too far. I, Ebere Bulam, I will not swear. You all know it is against my faith.
Yes.
You know what I believe in,
yes,
and I can't go back on it.
Have you seen it? Have you all seen it?
Don't mind him.
Ebere Bulam has refused to swear the oath. You see, he's telling lies, using his so-called religion to dupe innocent people, commit crimes, abominable crimes. That's it. That's
let him go.
Going.
Let him go. Let him go.
That's him going.
Let us go.
Let's go. Liar. Go. Liar.
Anyamele, you have taken my land this way. I'm not going to contest anything with you, but God is an impartial judge. Remember that.
You mean you have not seen the cause and shame you have brought to the entire family?
What cause? What shame?
Oh, any dear, you are asking me what cause and asking me what shame. I see. So you didn't hear the lamentations of Ebere Bulam, or for a man to have cried openly before the crowd because of his property that was forcibly snatched from him. Any dear, you have ruined me. You have overmortgaged my conscience. You've destroyed my entire family.
Shh, it's all right. Eh? It's night. People will start hearing our voice.
Let them hear, any dear. Let them hear. Now listen. I will not step into that land again.
You must take that land. You must possess that land.
No,
you
no.
must.
Any dear, look. That land is posing a threat to me. I can see death coming to me. I can see death coming to my entire family. Any dear, I will not step into that land again.
Then why did you go to start claiming it in the first place?
You are very stupid. You are foolish. Are you not the one that talked me into it?
If I talked you into it, why don't you allow me to talk you out of it?
Okay, better. That's very good. Now, talk me out of it.
Nai. Ha. Now you see, you make me laugh at times. Most times you make me believe that you don't have a heart. Not to think of believing in yourself. Now listen, man. When a man begins to allow fear grip his life, his days are numbered. Yes. Do you mean that you don't know that any curse placed on any person during oath taking can be removed? Or have you ever seen a situation where an evil spirit sent to kill someone was redirected to kill the person that sent it? Nine. You think I didn't know about all these things before I asked you to go and claim back that land? I know all this. It's okay. It's okay, my husband. There is no need to fear. There is no problem. Just hold on to your hands. Chidobidaka, please. Nothing will happen to you. Nine. You need some rest. We'll go in and take some rest together. Just nothing will happen to you. Let's go in and nine. Let's go in and rest.
Good morning.
Good morning, Emily.
I want to sweep the compound a little since the children are not around.
That's okay.
Okay.
But hurry up so that we can finish the discussion on that land matter.
Okay, okay. But now you eat before we continue with the discussion. I want to prepare some yam porridge for you.
That will not be necessary for now. Because I want us to discuss that land matter we started yesterday night.
Okay, I'm coming. I'm coming tonight.
Hurry up.
Papa. Mama. Considering the situation of things now, I want to take both of you out of this village. I've taken us to the city where I work now.
What is wrong with us staying here in the village? I think we are okay here.
Papa, everything is wrong. Absolutely everything. Papa. Number one, Osita, my brother, is dead. And the only piece of land which we feed on has been taken away from us. Papa, if I go back to the village, how are you people going to feed? Or are you going to borrow?
We can always manage. You know? We can always manage around here.
Manage what, Papa? What do you have here to manage? Papa, please, I am begging you. Papa, please, I want you to come with me. We are going to consider a body to you. Mama. What are we going to do for you then? Mama, how can you say this? So taking care of my own parents will not turn out to be a burden on me. Oh, Mama.
Listen, my daughter. You know what it means to take care of three adults in the city, considering how difficult things are today. Eh? Not only that, if we go to the city to stay with you, eat your food, what services are we going to render you? You mean we can't render you any assistance?
Papa, I do not need any assistance from you. I can confidently cater for both of you. I will. What am I even doing here? I will follow you.
I will also join you in the village, in the city. But I wouldn't stay too long. You know I belong here. Eh?
I know. I promise you, as long as you're going to stay there, I will take care of both of you very well.
It's okay, Mama.
Chaka! Shabona! The day has broken. And let it bring the fortune to the shrine of the Chaka.
Anyamele, my son.
Life.
I've heard all you said. You need not worry. I would equally find a lasting solution to your problem. None of those causes by a problem shall come.
Amen. Amen.
I'm going to give you a charm. This charm is like a substance. You are going to kill a goat in front of that farmland. Going to do this after 12 midnights. After killing the goat, pour this substance into the blood of the goat and stir properly. Now, after stirring it properly, such that no trace of the substance is found. Rub it on your face, at your back, in your forehead, then on the left side of your face, as well as the right side of your face. Then take a little quantity of it and do the same thing.
Nine. But all my children are in the city.
Then, when you get home, join hand with your wife and call out the names of the children. After calling out their names, raise the substance up together with your wife and direct it to all the four corners of your house. Then you come out of your house, spit 7 times and raise this substance up and throw it into the air. Then the demons will be at war with the man that placed this curse on you. Ochaka! Ochaka!
Streams of pain and sorrow.
Thank you very much.
Tears of the poor and helpless. Hearts are torn in anger. From where will their help come?
Mine, oh mine, hear them cry, their hearts call out. Hear them, Lord, their cry for help and for peace, remove from them.
So we feel so badly. Happiness no more known. Hurting the more we get. Save us this pang of pain.
From them, strains of pain.
hope is gone, my strength is gone. Where could he ever be? My heart is torn, my feet are weak.